Jesus.
Jesus paid the price. Now I'm free from
sin. Sold out. Let's do the second verse, come on. I come through the fire.
I come through the fire. I come through the rain. But God,
He never
let my side. He's my comfort through all earth and pain. I am sold out.
Come on, I'm sold out.
I am sold out.
Come on, clap your hand and say it.
I am sold out.
I'm sold out.
Somebody else! come through. Just like you did, Abraham. Lord, I need you to show me your sign. So today I challenge heaven, 'cause I feel in the spirit is manifestation time. So here I am, Jesus. All I have is your word. Show yourself to be God. I know you won't.
Welcome you to this pinnacle of proclamation known as the Mount Lebanon Baptist Church. We're located at 1141 Campostella Road in the wonderful city of Norfolk, Virginia. The zip code is 23523. And we welcome you this morning to be a part of the broadcast here coming from our sanctuary. We are so grateful to God for once again how he has blessed us. He's kept us all week long. As a matter of fact, God was so good this week, he even sent the rain our way to let us water the grass and the flowers, that the flowers will grow. So we're grateful on this day that we were able to come to say once again, as the psalmist said, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. And then the songwriter said, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. How wonderful it is that we've gathered again, that we can magnify his name together. If you don't know what that means, let me help you with it. That means that we got to lift him up together. But I'll lift up a little bit, and you lift up a little bit, and you lift up a little bit, and you lift up a little bit. And together, all of us lift up the mighty name of Jesus, our risen Savior and soon coming King, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. How wonderful is his name. For at the name of Jesus, one day every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord, to the glory of God. Amen and amen. So we welcome you this morning to be a part of the broadcast here at the Mount Lebanon Baptist Church. Join me now in prayer as we invite the presence of the Lord here in this place on this day. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you again for the privilege that you have provided for us, as well as the opportunity that we can come before the throne of grace once again.
We come because mercy suits our plea. We realize that we need you and we cannot do without you. So come, Holy Spirit, come, Heavenly Dove, with all thy quickening power, and breathe on these cold hearts of ours, that we may feel your presence once again and be reminded once again that thou art God and beside thee there is none other. For we've come to praise your name today, because we've come to worship you in spirit and in truth. So we ask right now that anything that hinders us, anything that holds us back from praising and worshiping you, move it right now in the name of Jesus, that we can worship you, the God of our salvation. And so we ask right now, Holy Spirit, that you would lead us, that all that we do and all that we say would be in right keeping and standard, the way that you would have us to go, and that we do it orderly according to your will and your way. We bless your name right now. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Join me this morning as the word comes from Luke chapter 7. I'm going to begin reading at verse number 1 this morning. Reading from the New King James Version. Luke chapter 7. I'm going to begin reading at verse number 1. Hear the word that Luke writes from his gospel this morning. He says, "Now when he concluded all his saying in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum, and a certain centurion servant who was dear to him was sick and ready to die. So when he heard about Jesus, he sent elders of the Jews to him, pleading with him to come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they begged him earnestly, saying that the one for whom he should do this was deserving, for he loves our nation and has built us a synagogue. Then Jesus went with them, and when he was already not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him, saying to him, 'Lord, do not trouble yourselves, for I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. And therefore, I did not even think myself worthy to come to you. But say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I also am a man placed under authority, having soldiers under me. And I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come, and he comes, and to my servant, do this, and he does it.' Jesus heard these things. He marveled at him and turned around and looked to the crowd that followed him. 'I say to you, I have not found such great faith, not even in Israel.' And those who were sent, returning to the house, found the servant well who had been sick." The word of the Lord on this morning. Amen. Praise be unto our God. I don't know about you this morning, but I'm glad to be in the service. One more time. Hear the words of the song this morning. Glad to be in the service. Just one more time. We're glad this morning that we're here. Amen.
Yeah.
to be in the service one more time. Amen, amen. Yes, yes, yes. I hear the words of the children that say, if you're glad, let your face know it sometimes. Amen, amen. So glad to be in the service. But we have announcements this morning as we come before you. This morning we ask that you continue to pray for many members who are on our sick list. And as we pray for them on Monday mornings and on Friday mornings. And you ought to pray for them because you ought to thank God your name is not on the list. Amen, somebody. Amen. So continue to lift up all the names that are on our sick list so that God will move in a mighty way and bless them. This weekend, we realize this is Memorial Day weekend. It's a time in which we honor those veterans, those individuals who served in the armed forces and who gave their life for us. So this weekend is a damn time that we remember those individuals who put their lives on the line for many of us, that we could have safety here in this country. So if you don't mind this morning, join me just for a moment right there, silent prayer. Let's pray for just silently this morning for those, as we honor those who've fallen. Amen. Amen. God bless you. I want to say thank you this morning for the individuals of our church family who were so kind on last weekend, particularly to the pastor support organization that they came and decided to have a cookout for the pastor on last week, on last Sunday, as we celebrated here on the grounds. For many of you came to celebrate with us, and we were so grateful for you. And I just want to say thank you to everybody, all those who were so kind to provide a gift of love or affection or just gave a kind word. Just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for all that you did to make my weekend and my day a great day on last Sunday. And yes, Malika, let me say to you, everybody loves Chick-fil-A. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Please join us on Monday and on Friday mornings for our prayer list, for our prayer call at 7 a.m. in the morning. You can also join us on Wednesday evening at 6:30 for our Bible study. We're studying from 2 Corinthians now. We've gone through 1 Corinthians. Now we're in 2 Corinthians. So come on and join us on Wednesday evening at 6:30, that we can study once again together. If you're interested in about our church, knowing when we're going to reopen, we will reopen on the first Sunday in July. You can come on the first Sunday in July, come on back in. We will have some guidelines for you to follow. We'll be passing that along to you. The trustees and diggers will be meeting in a couple weeks, so we will get everything in line for you, that we'll be prepared that when we come on the first Sunday in July. And we just ask that you follow our instructions. We all still want to be safe. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And on the fourth Sunday of June, we will be having a cookout here on the grounds, and that Sunday morning will be Youth Day, and we'll be celebrating our young people, and we have two seniors this year, Malika and Kimari, and we will be honoring them respectfully on the fourth Sunday. So come and be with us on the fourth Sunday, that we can recognize our children. We have great children in our church. You didn't hear that, but I'll say it again. We have great children in our church, and God has abundantly blessed them. So we thank you so kindly for what you're about to do to bless our children. I'm going to thank you in advance this morning. I want to say to every individual of our church, thank you so kindly for your giving, how faithful you've been to give through the pandemic, and we are so grateful that you continue to be faithful here to your church. We hope that when you come back in that you'll see some changes here. We're trying to get some things done, so we pray that we can get all that done before you get back in, because we want you to know that we're trying to use the gifts that you've given us in the correct way to bless this house known as Mount Lebanon Baptist Church. So I want to say thank you for your giving. For those of you who want to give, you might not be able to come to the church to give, or might not be able to even mail it in, you can just use your smartphone. You can go on your phone right there, and you can text 73256, and in the message down the bottom, put in MLBC, and it'll prompt you there for how you can give. You can give right from your smartphone. If you don't want to do it that way, you can go on your computer, your tablet, and you can go to the website, mlbcnorfolk.com, and you can give there. Just go to the link, and you can give from that perspective right there. So we thank you for your giving to the household of faith. This is the fifth Sunday of the month, and the fifth Sunday of the month, we always give way to one of the associate ministers of our church, and this morning there is a preacher in the house. He goes by the name of Reverend George Ross. He was sent to us all the way from the big state of Minnesota. Amen. He's here now in warm weather. Don't know how to act in warm weather now. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we're just so grateful that the Lord sent him our way, him and his wonderful wife, Sister Rhonda. And they were a part of our church family. This morning we give way to him that he would come and present the word of God. He's a proclaimer of the word of God. He can preach. He knows how to preach, and he will preach the unadulterated gospel of Jesus Christ. So after we listen to the words of the song, In Spite of Me, the next voice you would hear will be that of Reverend George Ross, associate minister here of Mount Lebanon Baptist Church in Norfolk. In Spite of Me.
Every teeth, I don't doubt every eye. Got more flaws than a little, and I messed up a thousand times. I don't always commit. Sometimes I give up way too quick, and then I get tired of trying to run away from who I am to who I wanna be. Some days are better than others. I can be up and I'm down. But beyond my mistakes, found in your grace, and this one thing will never change. You still love me, in spite of me. You still chose me, can it be? Every time you see it all, you see it all. You still love me. Sometimes my mother's mind can be insecure. Oh,
the church say amen. Church say amen again. Amen, amen. It is truly, truly a blessing to be back in the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen, amen. Let's go. Let's give God a hand, praise. Amen, amen. Grace and peace be with you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. It is truly, truly a blessing to be with you once again. And I am humbly grateful for the opportunity to be standing here before you. It is an opportunity that I do not take lightly. Amen? Amen. Once again, if you have your copies of God's Word, turn back to the Gospel of Luke. The Gospel of Luke. Let us pray. Father God, right now I come to you in the precious name of Jesus. Thanking you, Father, for yet another opportunity, Father God, to stand here before your people. Now, right now, in the name of Jesus, Father God, I just ask you to have your way within me, that your people may hear from you, Father. So right now, just move me out of the way, Father God, and have your way, that your word will touch hearts this morning. And we'll be sure to give you the praise, Father, and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. The chapter of Luke. I'm going to read that again, the chapter of the Luke chapter number 7. I will be reading from the New International Version. The New International Version. Wherein we find these words. When Jesus had finished saying all this in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum. There's a centurion servant whom his master valued highly, was sick and about to die. The centurion heard of Jesus and sent some elders of the Jews to him, asking him to come and heal his servant. When they came to Jesus, they pleaded earnestly with him. This man deserves to have you do this because he loves our nation and has built our synagogue. So Jesus went with them. He was not far from the house when the centurion sent his friends to say to him, Lord, don't trouble yourself, for I did not deserve to have you come under my roof. That is why I did not even consider myself worthy to come to you. But say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I myself am a man under authority, with soldiers under me. I tell this one, go, and he goes. And that one, come, and he comes. I say to my servant, do this, and he does it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed at him. And turning to the crowd following him, he said, I tell you, I have not found such great faith, even in Israel. Then the men who had been sent returned to the house and found the servant well. This ends the reading. May God add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his most holy word. Amen. 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 If I had to tag this message this morning, I would simply tag it. Am I deserving? Am I deserving? You know, church, have you ever wondered why some people act the way they do? Act like they own the world. I walk around like folks owe them something, amen? Those folks walk around with a chip on their shoulders. You ever walk down the street and see somebody walking towards you, and they cross over. They cross over in the middle of the street just so they won't come in contact with you, so that they won't be able to look you in the eyes. Some folks might call this arrogant, amen? Come on now. You ever come across anybody like that? That person who thinks they are deserving of everything, no matter what. That person who God has blessed. And when they look in the mirror, they pat their own selves on the back, thinking that they did or got what they have all by themselves. Yo, come on, y'all know what I'm talking about. You ever run across anybody like that? I'm here this morning to share with you, to talk about someone who was just the opposite. Someone who actually felt like he wasn't deserving or worthy of the Lord's blessing. I'm here this morning to give you just a glimpse of someone who had faith that some folks that walk with Jesus didn't even have. Come on now, hit me this morning. When we read this piece of scripture, we see that there are three main characters, amen? We'll say four, with Jesus being the headliner. Come on now, talk to me. We have the Jewish elders. We have the Roman centurion. And then we have the centurion's servant. Now we know from our studying that a centurion is a Roman army soldier, a Gentile, who back then had was in charge of 80 to 100 men. But we also see that this centurion must have heard about someone named Jesus. He must have heard about Jesus's healing power. Amen? This centurion knew the power that Jesus had to heal his servant. Church, the Bible says that his servant was very sick and was about to die. So he called the elders of the church. Come on, talk to me. He called the elders of the church and asked them to go out and find this man named Jesus and asked him to come to his house to heal his servant. If you look at verse number 4, now don't miss this now. It says, when they came to Jesus, they pleaded with him, saying, this man deserves to have you do this because he loves our nation and has built our synagogues for us to worship. Amen? Now, don't forget, they're talking about a Gentile. They're talking about a Roman soldier and telling Jesus that, hey, Jesus, this man deserves your blessing. Come on, talk to me. This Roman soldier, this one who has oppressed them, they tell this man, Jesus loves our nation and has built our synagogues. You know, church, just consider this for a moment. I think this says a lot about this centurion. Come on, talk to me. This centurion, yeah, just consider this for a moment. Maybe, just maybe, Pastor, excuse me. Just maybe this centurion has some kind of love of Christ already in him. Come on, talk to me. Really, look at the humility. Look at the humility of this guy. You see, in verse 6 and 7, the Bible says that Jesus was not far from the house when the centurion sent some of his homies to meet him and saying, Jesus, and I'm presuming it was on the road because it says to him, Lord, they say, don't trouble yourself. For I do not deserve to have you come even under my roof. That is why I did not even consider myself worthy to come to you. You see, church, it's one thing for other folks to think of you as deserving or worthy, but it's another to think of yourself. Come on, talk to me. I'll say that again. It's another thing to think of yourself worthy. Amen? Amen, somebody. Remember what Proverbs 16:18 says.
It says pride goes before destruction, a haughty spirit before a fall. You see, proud people take little account of their weaknesses and do not anticipate stumbling blocks. Y'all with me? They think that they are above the frailties of us common folk. Come on, talk to me. Somebody hear me this morning. But here we're looking at this centurion. He wasn't motivated. Here it is. He wasn't motivated by pride, but by a humble faith. Y'all still with me? Amen, amen. He was someone that we can all look at and try to emulate. Amen. So you see, we don't know how this Roman came to know Jesus. We don't know if he himself even saw Jesus, or he may have met someone that Jesus performed a miracle on. The Bible really doesn't say. But one thing we see for sure is that he had the confidence in Jesus. Amen? He had the confidence in Jesus and his power to heal. Come on, talk to me. Let's look at a few things and that moved this Roman soldier, this Gentile, to send for Jesus to heal his servant. First, I'm almost done. He must have believed in the God of the Jewish people. Y'all hear me this morning? Now, this is why the Bible says the elders were able to go to Jesus and say to him, "Lord, this man deserves this because he loves our nation and built our synagogue." Now notice, they didn't say, excuse me, "Jesus, we deserve for you to do this." Amen. Amen, somebody. You see, folks, it's right. They didn't say that we ourselves. They went on the behalf of this centurion. Amen? So it's all right. It's all right for us to go to Jesus on behalf of somebody else. Y'all hear me this morning? I'll say that again. It's all right for us to go to Jesus on behalf of somebody else. It's all right in our daily prayer to pray for someone else to be blessed. Come on, talk to me. To pray for someone else to be healed. Yeah, I'm telling you this morning, I'm not saying don't pray for yourself. No, I'm saying let's not be so selfish with the Lord's blessings that we want to keep them all to ourselves. Let's get rid of that I, me, mine mentality and truly think of others and love our neighbor as ourselves. Come on, y'all hear me this morning? And second, we see that this centurion had faith. Listen now, he had faith that Jesus himself commended. Jesus says that this centurion had not only faith, Jesus said he had great faith. Come on, y'all talk to me this morning. Verse 9 says, when Jesus heard this, he was amazed at him. And turning to the crowd following him, he said, "I tell you, I have not found such great faith even in Israel." Amen, amen. Now, we have to assume that when Jesus said this, that there were, even his disciples were also in that crowd. Come on, talk to me. but here is a Gentile being commended for his faith by Jesus. When Jesus heard the words of the centurion's homies, he was shocked. He must have stopped right in his tracks. Think about it. Here's Jesus walking to the centurion's house. And all of a sudden they say to Jesus, Jesus, you don't have to go. The centurion says to just say the word. Y'all missed that, didn't you? He said, you don't have to come, Jesus. He said, wherever you are, just say the word and my servant will be healed. Come on, talk to me, D. Can you imagine the look on Jesus' face saying, wow, this centurion has great faith. Amen, somebody. The third thing we see here is that the centurion, he understood that Jesus was operating under authority. Uh-huh. Come on, talk to me. Look at verse number 8. This centurion uses himself to compare himself with Jesus. He said, for I myself am a man under authority with soldiers under me. I tell this one, go, and he goes, and that one, come, and he comes. I say to my servant, do this, and he does it. This centurion believed in the power of Jesus. He was confident in Jesus. He believed in the authority of Jesus. Amen, amen. He knew that what Jesus commanded would be done. You hear me this morning? He knew that the words of Jesus were enough to heal his sick servant. Come on with me. That's right. The Bible don't say it. The Bible don't say what words Jesus used. Look at it. It doesn't say what words Jesus used to heal the servant. But this centurion knew that he didn't have to be where Jesus was for his servant to be healed. Come on, talk to me. He knew that Jesus didn't have to come to his house to heal his servant. This centurion knew that Jesus didn't have to send a doctor to the house to look after his sick servant. Y'all still with me? Amen, somebody. Amen, amen. Look at faith. Look at the faith of this centurion, this Roman, this Gentile soldier. It was his faith. The Bible says that if you have the faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move mountains. That faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Can you just picture in your mind the faith of this centurion soldier? If you have faith, you can call on Jesus to just say the word. And he'll say it not only for you, but he'll say it in the name of your neighbor. He'll say it in the name of a family member. He'll say it in the name of your spouse. Amen. He'll say it in the name of that person in the hospital. He'll say it in the name of your finances. He'll say it in the name of anything that you're looking to have. Jesus will say the word. All you have to do is have faith. Amen. All you have to do is just call on him. Just call on him. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Let's give God a hand praise. Let's give God a hand praise. Amen. We thank God for Jesus. Amen. We thank God for his healing power. We thank God for that. All we have to do is call on him, and he will be there. All we have to do is call on him. We have to have great faith. Bible says great faith. But one thing we can't do, you can't put faith in a bottle. You can't put faith in a bottle. I'm gonna share this just for a moment. You can't put faith in a bottle and measure it. Amen. Amen, somebody. Y'all with me? The Bible says that he had great faith. The Bible also says if you have faith the size of a mustard seed. Amen. So don't, you can't measure your faith. Just have faith. Amen. Just have faith and trust in God to do the rest. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Thank God for his word this morning. Thank God for his word. Amen. There may be somebody here who have heard the word this morning, and the word has touched your heart. Someone who wants to have that relationship with Jesus the Christ. Someone who is asking, who might ask the question, what must I do to be saved? Well, I'm glad you asked me that question. The Bible tells us here in Romans 10:9 that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God did raise him from the dead, you shall be saved. So if you say that prayer this morning and you believe and you confess, all you have to do is come to him. All you have to do is come to him. I just pray that when you do it, if you're weak in your faith, that you find someone that you can walk with. Find someone that you can hold, that will hold your hand and walk you through this life, through life's journey, because we're all on this journey together. Amen? Yeah. Amen. You're not alone. You're not alone. Thank you for God's word this morning. Amen. 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 Let us stand. Father, once again, we thank you for your word, Father. We thank you for allowing us the opportunity to share with your people your word. Now, Father, we just pray right now in the name of Jesus that your word does not find itself on fertile ground, that your word, Father God, will touch the hearts, that it will move in each and every one of us, Father God, in the direction that you would want us to go, that your will may be done in all of our lives. So right now, Father God, we just ask you to lead, God, and direct our steps as we depart from this place, but never from your presence. Right now, in the name of Jesus, Father, we just thank you and thank you. Amen. 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 Let us go in peace. Amen.